think the flying machine really is the spirit of Chopin himself. It's the spirit of him and his music. It's the embodiment of the fact that music in general.
The things about the flying machine that makes it special also makes it a real prima donna and definitely the hardest actor that I've ever had to work with. Flying Machine started as a half-hour animated film. It's about a flying machine, which is a very complicated model to animate.
We had to create an animatic, which is a kind of special pre-visualization of the film in the computer.
The animatic's absolutely vital. It really is a backbone for the whole film. We make the film before we make the film. Most live action shoots have a ratio of we go and film a lot and then we only use some of it. Whereas in animation we need to try and only shoot what we want. So having a good storyboard is vital, so we don't shoot more than we use.
It is not a character that you would normally use in a stop motion film because of its size and its complexity. But we felt that you could bring a beautiful, handmade, fantastical feeling to this machine if it was made in stop motion. You have animators who are manipulating puppets and moving them one frame, taking a still photo, moving it a bit more, taking another photo. So an animator is essentially acting at very slow speed. We had 14 flying machines. We had one big flying machine with the wings, which was 2 meters high and had 122 moving joints, which meant that the animators had to move the puppet 122 times for every single frame. We have 120,000 individual frames. 112,000 frames are created and manipulated as individual stills. Combining live action with stop motion animation, with CG backgrounds, in other places with painted backgrounds, and all of this we were doing in stereoscopic in 3D. We have to shoot a left eye and a right eye, so it doubles the workload and doubles the opportunity for things to go wrong.
But on the other hand, the new vistas that it opens up in the same way that 3D gives a whole new depth of experience to the audience. 3D really does enable you to have the sensation of going through the wall, through the page, through the screen into an extra dimension of experience.
I was totally shocked by the effect of 3D's effect. It feels so real, and just feel that you are in that film and you are experiencing the same thing that the characters inside of that movie is experiencing.
It makes you feel you're more in the world because it's not just on a flat screen, but it's all around you.
You're able to sort of feel these objects much more intensely than if you were just looking at a flat 2D image.
The challenge of the visual effects was the fact that we were combining so many different elements. We had paintings, matte paintings in terms of digitally created backgrounds. We had CG, fully CG 3D environments. We had to put this together with stop motion and live action in 3D.
The most difficult visual effects shot in this film is the gherkin shot.
We had to cut out rotoscope and then we had to situate this set on top of a skyscraper in the middle of London. This is the longest shot in stop motion history. It's the magic dance between Dad and Anna. That shot was an epic journey in terms of the shooting. We were planning it for 3 months. We took 3 months to build the set. We took another 3 months to shoot the shot. So the shot took 9 months to actually prepare and shoot. And then the challenge of rotoscoping it. We had one person rotoscoping that shot for 2 months. That was just cleaning the shot before we got to the stage where we actually started doing the visual effects. My expectations for the flying machine are, well, actually, I'm just curious. There has never been a film in the history of cinema ever made like the flying machine. In terms of the structure of the narrative, the techniques that we've used, and the way that we've combined the narrative and the filmmaking techniques. So I'm just very, very curious to see what the world makes of it. Personally, I think that the animation that we've done is, you know, probably the best stop motion that has been made. Until you're home and stay with me. People have a lot of affection for stop motion animation. We're dealing with dolls and we're dealing with puppets, so it appeals to children and, you know, and it has very wide appeal.
The flying machine is a kind of magical tool.
It's a perfect metaphor and representation of Chopin's music. Chopin's music is liberating, it's transporting. It makes you feel like you're flying.
You know, I have a lot of dreams about flying. If I had a flying machine, I'd fly everywhere. There wouldn't be a place I wouldn't want to fly over.